Meanwhile, a funeral for an Irving toddler strangled allegedly at the hands of her mother is set for today. 911 tapes offer details into why the attack on the brother and the sister happened. Channel 8's Cynthia Vega joins us live from the Lucera Justice Center in Dallas, where the mother is being held this morning. Cynthia, good morning.
Good morning, Chris. 30-year-old Saika Akhtar is spending her first night here at the Dallas County Jail as we're now learning more disturbing details about those moments leading up to when police found her two children strangled.
Saika Akhtar wore handcuffs and a green jumpsuit, saying nothing as deputies escorted her to Dallas County Jail. She's charged with the unthinkable, murdering her own children. The married mother revealing her motive in this 911 call.
They are autistic. Both are autistic.
Both are what, dear?
Autistic. I don't want my kids to be like that.
They're both autistic?
I want normal kids.
Akhtar called 911 from her Irving apartment Monday evening, calmly saying she used a wire to strangle her 6-year-old son and her 3-year-old daughter. She also revealed what she'd tried minutes earlier.
First, I tried to give them the bathroom cleaner, I put in their mouth, but they don't bring it. I want them to bring it, they don't bring it. So there's a wire near, so I just grab their neck and then I try so many times and then they are no more.
Parents of autistic children think Akhtar lost hope, likely felt isolated, perhaps even ostracized.
What it is like to raise a child on the spectrum who is escaping the house, climbing on top, you find them on top of your kitchen cabinets, breaking things, throwing things, unable, and most of the time it's because they're trying to communicate and they're not able to.
Akhtar's son, Zane, was buried yesterday. His sister, Fariel, will be buried later today following a funeral service scheduled at 2 o'clock this afternoon at the Dallas Central Mosque in Richardson. Reporting live here at the Dallas County Jail, I'm Cynthia Vega, Channel 8 News.